I knew I was going to be a geologist probably from the age of about four. My father was a mining engineer by training, although he never ever did mining engineering. But he always used to take me to the mines looking for minerals and things like that. So that got me into geology. And then it was pure chance that I ended up on a ship. It's very difficult to say. It's getting better all the time. I think there's so little known about our planet that the more experience you get, and I really hadn't realized this for the last few years, actually the more things you see and the more things you notice that don't quite fit to the theories. So we've been sailing around the South Atlantic trying to work out how the Earth's plates move apart and how that links to the amount of water that circulates in the crust. And we're really finding out some really cool stuff. But we've been to the Red Sea and found huge underwater salt glaciers falling down from the flanks of the Red Sea into the Central Valley. Every day is just a great experience. Our new home, I don't see people living on the deep sea. I think they'd miss the sunlight. I mean, when you dive to the surface, to the bottom of the ocean, then after about 300 meters down, there isn't much sunlight. And I think personally, I'd miss that a bit. Do what you love most. That's what I say to every student. Do what you love most, because that's what you do with absolute commitment. And it's the commitment that makes it fun. If you get up in the morning and you're not looking forward to going, you probably didn't do the right thing. And a lot of the things I also tell students is use your brain. It's the one thing you've got that nobody else has got. You know, everybody else has got a ship, everybody else has got measurement, equipment and stuff. What they don't have is your brain. Use your brain. I am optimistic. I think we're going to see some changes. We're already seeing some changes. I think a lot of us think the ocean now is pristine, or 20 years ago was pristine. It wasn't. We've impacted it for at least 100 years. So it's changed already. I don't think there's a very big problem to know what did the ocean really look like before humans came along and started messing with it. So I'm optimistic that the ocean in some form will survive. I'm optimistic as well that humankind is, we're all pretty stupid, but there comes a point when we realize we've been stupid and we're quite capable of changing that. So I'm not a pessimist from nature, but I think it'll be okay.